Hi, welcome to Digital Principles and System Design. In this video lecture, let's discuss about various representations of Boolean expressions. Given any Boolean expression, a Boolean variable or a binary variable, we call this as a binary variable because x can take any one of 0 or 1 as value. But preferably we refer to this as Boolean variable, and a Boolean variable can appear in a Boolean expression either in the normal form or in the complemented form. So if you simply represent x, it is in the normal form. If we have the complement, we use to represent with prime or the bar. So if there are two Boolean variables, say x and y, and we apply a binary operation over these variables. Binary operation because, see, binary logical operation. Binary means we have two inputs to the operation. For example, AND operation. We can compute AND operation when we have two inputs to it. So unary operator is we have single operand to the operation and we compute the operation. Say for example minus 5, it is a unary operator. Complement is a unary operator. We have only one operand to the operation complement. Binary operator means we will have two inputs to the operation. For example, the AND operation, OR operation, etc. So we'll consider a binary operation with two Boolean inputs. Then how many different expressions are possible is the question. Okay, so since each of the variable here can take one of the two forms, either the normal form or the complemented form, we have two choices. Okay, so that is the base 2, and since that we have two variables, we have 2 to the power 2 number of different expressions that we can form with this single operation. For example, if x and y are the variables, by Boolean variables, and we apply the logical operation AND, we get xy, x bar y, xy bar and x bar y bar. Four different expressions we can obtain using these two variables and a binary operator. In general, if we have n binary variables or n Boolean variables, each of the variable can have one of the two forms, normal form or the complemented form. So the base is 2 and we have n different variables, so 2 to the power n different expressions we can form using a binary operator. Any Boolean expression can take one of the two forms, either the standard form or the canonical form. The standard form, again, we can represent in two different ways, either as sum of products or product of sum. Similarly, the canonical form we can represent using sum of min terms or the product of max terms. Now, what is sum of product? Okay, consider this example. F is a function with three inputs A, B and C, and this is an expression represented in sum of product in standard notation. We have A plus B bar C. Now each of this sub expression is a product and we have sum of products. Okay, that's why it is called SOP, sum of products. The product of sum is that we have products, here we have a single element and a product between the sum. So we have sums, in between them we have products, so it is product of sum. So with standard form, I can either represent a function using sum of product or product of sum notation. In canonical form, we can represent the Boolean function either as sum of min terms or the product of max terms. What is a min term? Okay, see here, f is a function with three variables, and if you consider the expression, Boolean expression, each of this product is called a min term. Here in standard notation, we call this as product. A is a product, B bar C is a product. Here, the difference between this product and the min term is that here the number of literals in each of the product is variable. Here I have only one literal. Literal is the Boolean variable either in its original form or the complemented form. So here I have only one literal. In this product we have two literals. But in min terms, the number of literals involved in the product will be the same. And it is equal to the number of variables in the function. So if there are three variables in the function, then each of the min term will have three literals. And that is why it is called min term, and this we simply call as a product. And max term, the same difference. Here, the in each of the sum, the number of literals might vary. Here, the sum has only one literal. Here, we have two literals. But here, max term will have the same number of literals as in the input, separated by the OR operation. So, why should we call this product as min term and this sum as max term? We call this product as min term because the satisfiability of this term is minimal. What is satisfiability? When we get the output of this product to be 1, then we call that this expression as satisfied. And how many combinations of values will get me this expression, only this product, okay? How many combinations of values to A, B and C will make me this sub expression A bar B bar C equal to 1? There is only one possibility, right? A bar should be 1, B bar should be 1 and C should be 1. Then only I can get this product to be 1. So I have very minimal choice. I have only one choice for this term to get 1 as output. That is, the satisfiability is minimum. That is why it is called min term. Whereas this sum is called max term. Why? Because the satisfiability is more or many. There are many combinations of values which can make the sum equal to 1. For example, A bar can be 1, B bar, C bar can be 0, and only B bar can be 1, A bar and C can be 0, or only C is 1, A bar and B bar is 0. Otherwise, I can have A bar and B bar to be 1, both of them to be 1 and C is 0. And I have all the three can be 1. There are many choices, okay. So, that is why it is called max term. The satisfiability of the sum is maximum. That is why it is called max term. And the difference between the standard notation and the canonical form is that each of the sub expression, whether it is sum of product or the product of sum, each of the, here the sub expression, number of literals in the sub expression will be varying, whereas in the canonical form, the number of literals in the min term or the max term will be the same as that of the input. Let's now see how to represent the Boolean function using sum of min terms. Here we have three inputs, x, y and z, and we have listed all possible combination of binary values. And each of the combination of the input we can represent using a min term. When x is taking the value 0, in the min term the literal will be appearing as a complemented form. So when x takes the value 0, it will be appearing as x bar. Similarly, y takes 0, so it appears as y bar. And similarly, z will appear as z bar as z is taking the value 0. If it takes the value 1, it will appear as the normal term. So 0, 0, 1 will be represented as x bar, y bar, z. Similarly here 1, 0, 0, x, y bar, z bar, because y and z takes the value 0. And each of the min term is designated uniquely by the terms small m0, m1, etc. up to m7. And consider a function f1, Boolean function f1, which is taking the value 1 for the min terms m4, m5 and m7. So in this case, we will write the Boolean function f1 with the min terms for which the output is 1. So we will have m4, so we will have this corresponding expression x, y bar, z bar, and we have x, y bar, z, and finally m7, which is x, y, z, is separated by the OR operation. I need not express this Boolean function f1 using this literals. Rather, I can write it as f1 equal to m4 plus m5 plus m7, because each of this min term has unique representation of the min term with literals. So I can if we write it as m4, we should be able to write it as x, y bar, z bar. This sum we can represent using the sigma, and we will write it as m4 comma m5 comma m7. Sometimes we will take this m, small m, out, and we will write here sigma m, and we will simply give 4 comma 5 comma 7. All the representations are one and the same, representing the Boolean function f1 using sum of min terms. Now let's consider this example and try to write the Boolean function y in terms of the sum of min terms. Here, since we are writing the sum of min terms, I should consider only the min terms whose output is 1. So we have 3 combinations, so we will have 3 min terms separated by the OR operation, and then we will realize the circuit also. So 0, 1 for A and B, we will get the min term to be A bar B, because A is 0, so this will appear as A bar, and this is B is 1, so this will appear as B. So this is the first min term. The second min term for which y is 1 is 1, 0. So we have A, B bar, and finally we have 1, 1, which is A, B. And all the min terms we have to separate using the OR operation, which is the sum of min terms. And we can realize this circuit using the AND gate and OR gate, and complement we can realize using the NOT operation. Since NOT is the topmost prior operation, we will obtain the NOT operation first. Using the NOT gate, we compute A bar, we compute B bar, and we compute A bar B here using this AND gate, the first term, and AB bar the second term, and finally AB the third term, and we can give the output of the AND gates to OR gate to get the sum of min terms. Next we will consider the product of max terms. Here again we have 3 inputs x, y, z, and we have listed out all possible combinations of values that x and x, y and z can take. And max terms, we write it like if we have the value 0 for a variable, we represent using the normal notation. If it takes the value 1, we will represent using the complemented notation. And in between the literals, instead of AND operation, now we will have the OR operation. So 0, 0, 0 will be represented as x plus y plus z, and it is denoted by capital M0. Similarly, So take 0, 1, 0, we have x plus y bar plus z, and it is denoted by m2 and so on. So if you consider the max term, it is the complement of the min term. If you take the corresponding term here, 0, 0, 0, the min term corresponding to this is x bar, y bar, z bar. And if you take the complement of this, we get x bar y bar z bar the whole bar. And when you apply the De Morgan's law, we get x plus y plus z. And that is the max term corresponding to this combination. So each of the min term, small m0 is complement of capital m0 and vice versa. And this is true for every min term and max term. To represent the Boolean function f2 using product of max terms, we'll consider the terms for which the function takes the value of 0. So here there are 3 zeros, so we'll have 3 max terms corresponding to these zeros. Okay, so m1, we have x plus y plus z bar, that is the first term. Second term is m3, which is x plus y bar plus z bar, and the last term is m6, which is x bar plus y bar plus z, and in between each of the max term we have the product. So it is product of max terms. And since we know that this is m1, this is m3 and m6, we can write it like this. And notationally we can write the product using this pi symbol. And we can write it as pi of m1, m3, m6. That is the product of these max terms. Let's consider an example. There are 3 inputs to this function a, b and c. And y is the output. And we wanted to realize this function y using product of max terms. And we wanted to realize the circuit as well. So we have to consider the terms, max terms corresponding to the output 0. So we have 2 max terms which will be separated by products. The max term corresponding to 1, 0, 0 is, when you have 1, we have to represent using complemented notation. So we have C bar plus B plus A, and here everything is 1, so all will be complemented. So C bar plus B bar plus A bar, in between the max terms we have the product. So we have OR gate to compute these sum, and then finally we will add we will make an AND of all the max terms to get the function y. Here it is worth to note that we compute the OR operation and then we compute the AND operation. Why? Because the priority, although the AND operation has the higher precedence over the OR operation, we have increased the priority of OR operation using the brackets here. When you have brackets, those are the operations which will get the topmost priority. So we have to consider this expressions within the bracket first. So this expression will be one thing that will be executed or evaluated, and this will be parallelly evaluated. Both are having the equal precedence, and within this bracket now we have to apply the precedence. Now here we have a NOT operation. So NOT operation will happen first, C bar happens first, and that is what is given as input to the OR operation. And the result of now this sub expression will be evaluated, and this sub expression will also be evaluated, and the result of the sub expression will be fed to the AND gate to get the result. We can represent the same Boolean function either with sum of min terms or product of max terms. Consider this example. We have 3 inputs and we are to write this function y with both sum of min terms and product of max terms. So when we write sum of min terms, we will consider the output, min terms for which the output is 1. So there are 4 terms, which is m3, m5, m6 and m7, and we will separate those things with the OR operation, and we get the representation of the Boolean function y in sum of min terms. The same function y, when we wanted to represent using the product of max terms, we will use the max terms for which the output is 0. So we have 4 such terms corresponding to m0, m1, m2 and m4, and that is what we have written here, m0, and each of the max term will be separated by the AND operation. So m0 and m1 and m2 and m4, and these are the expressions corresponding to this one. You might be wondering how writing the same function using min term and max term will be the same, because with min term we are considering the output 1 and for max term we consider the output 0. Okay, how both will be same might be a question. The answer to this is this line. Now consider y1 as the function of y with min terms. That is, when we write y with sum of min terms, I am representing that y as y1, and we are writing y1 bar. So when we have y1, which is the y represented in sum of min terms, we will have m3, m5, m6 and m7. All these min terms will be separated by OR operation. Now when you compute the complement of this, we have to consider the output for which it is 0, right? Because complement, if y is giving the output 1, y bar should give 0. So I'll consider all the output with 0. That will be the y bar. So we have m0 plus m1 plus m2 plus m4. See here, these are all min terms. We are writing y1 bar with min terms. Now when you take the complement of y bar, you will get y1. So it is y1 double bar. So we get m0 plus m1 plus m2 plus m4 the whole bar. Now we know that we can apply De Morgan's law here, and we know that small m0 is complement to capital M0 and vice versa, right? So I can write this as m0, the complement of this, and the OR operator will become AND operator here. So we get capital M0, M1, M2 and M4, which is the same function y represented in product of max terms. Or equivalently, we can use the Boolean algebra to derive this. We start with y1 bar as usual. So we have m0 plus m1 plus m2 plus m4, and we have written the corresponding min terms corresponding to these things, and now we compute the whole bar. We can apply the involution and the De Morgan's law. So we have x bar, y bar, z bar, the whole bar by involution, and when you apply De Morgan's law, we will get a product for each of this R, and you can apply this here. We'll get x double bar plus y double bar plus z double bar, and this we know that x double bar, we know that it is x. Similarly, plus y double bar, we know that it is y. Similarly for z. And here this term, when you apply the whole bar, we have x double bar plus y double bar plus z bar. So we can simplify each of these terms, and we can see that this is exactly the y2, which is nothing but what is this, x plus y plus z is m0. and that is what we have here. And x plus y plus z bar is actually m1, and that is what we have here. Okay, x bar plus y bar plus z, and that is what we, sorry, it is a max term, right? So it is x plus y plus z bar, and that is what is m1. And m2 we have x plus y bar z, and finally the m4, which is x bar plus y plus z. So we have started with sum of min term, and we have found the same function represented in sum of, or the product of, max term. Now we'll see how to convert the Boolean expression represented using sum of products, that is the standard form. And in standard form we have represented using sum of products this Boolean function to be represented in sum of min terms, that is in the canonical form. Take for example, f is a function with three inputs a, b and c, and it is equal to a plus b bar c. Now we have to, this is in the standard form, we have to convert this into sum of min term form, which is a canonical form. So we take this function and we use the identity element, and we can multiply a into 1, which will result in a itself, right? So I can multiply with 1, and this 1 I can use the complement rule and write this 1 as b plus b bar, because b plus b bar is equal to 1. Why I am using b plus b bar? Because in this term I do not have b, okay, or c. So we will introduce one by one. So to start with, we introduce b. So we distribute this AND operation over the OR operation, and we get AB or AB bar, and this term is as such. Now these two terms, we do not have C, so I use complement, identity again, and introduce this one, and in this term we do not have A, so I introduce identity for this term as well. This one we will write it as C plus C bar, because C is missing here. This one we will write it as A plus A bar, because A is missing here. Now we can use the distributive law and multiply and get it. Now some terms when we multiply like this might be repeating. Say for example, A B bar C is repeating, and we can use the idempotent law to eliminate the duplicate terms, because X plus X is equal to X in Boolean algebra, that is the idempotent law. So we can eliminate the duplicate elements and have only one copy of them. And finally we ended with all the product terms with equal number of literals, and the number of literals will be equal to the number of inputs that we have in the function. So we have converted the Boolean function represented in sum of products to sum of min terms. Suppose if we are given the Boolean expression in sum of min terms and we wanted to convert to sum of products form, what should we do? We have to apply the Boolean rules and simplify the expression and come to this one. Okay, so this is the simplified expression. So we have to apply these rules in the reverse order and simplify this expression given in sum of min terms, and finally we will arrive at as sum of products. This is mere simplification of Boolean expression. Next we will see how to convert an expression given in sum of products to product of max terms. Now to start with, we have sum of products. This we have to convert to sum of min terms, the same procedure that we have discussed now. So we will introduce identity element and introduce the missing literals and get the sum of min terms first. And then we have to convert this sum of min terms, the Boolean expression, in sum of min terms to product of max term. This procedure also we have already seen. To obtain the product of max term, we complement the f bar. So whichever term that is missing here, that we will write it. So m0 is missing, that we will write. M1 is available here, m2 is missing, so m2 will write it here. M3 is here, m4 will write, and m5 will write, and m6 and m7 are available in f. So in complement we have m0, m2, m4 and m5, and we have represented the complement in sum of min term itself. Now we have to complement this once again so that we will get f. When we complement this, we get this expression with whole complement, and we have to apply the De Morgan's law. So we will apply a x bar plus y bar, y double bar plus z. So you will get x bar plus y plus z for this term, and this R operation will become AND operation. And then we have x bar plus y plus z, okay, that is the second term, and so on. Okay, so and this one we will know, we know that this is x bar, right? So this is 1 0 1, so it is m5, this is m4, m2, and this is m0. So this is the product of max term. Thus we have converted the Boolean function represented in sum of products to product of max term. Sometimes the Boolean function might be represented like this, which is a non-standard notation. Why it is non-standard? Because it doesn't fall either in sum of products or product of sum. It is mixing both. Okay. When we have such non-standard notation, when we realize the circuit, we'll realize it like this. Okay, AB we compute using this AND gate, and D plus E we compute using this OR gate, and then this product we compute using this AND gate, and finally this OR operation we compute here. Now what is the problem with this one? Here the number of levels is 3. That is, I can compute AB and D plus E parallelly, and this AND gate can operate, and I can get a valid result only after I get the output of this OR gate, that is after computing D plus E. So this AND gate will wait for this OR gate to produce the result, and this OR gate will produce the result only after it is getting the result from this AND gate and this OR gate. And this AND gate, say for example, if there is a uniform delay with each of this gates, that is after applying the input, say for example, it takes 1 unit of time to produce the output. So at time T0, you are, say for example, time T0, you are applying all the inputs. So I will get the output of this AND gate, which is AB at time unit 1. Again D plus E I can get at the time unit 1, because it will take 1 unit of time, assuming, okay, 1 unit of time to compute the result after the application of the input. Now the C is available at T0 itself, but this output D plus E is available only after time unit 1. So I can produce the result of this AND gate only at time unit 2, because only at time unit 1 I get this input. And this one, although this input is available at time unit 1, I do not get the input of this line, and this gate has to wait for 2 units of time, and this will produce the output at the third unit of time. So the delay involved in the circuit will be more. But if you convert this expression to standard notation, okay, this is in sum of product form, right? So here we can implement this circuit using two levels. So all the products will be parallelly computed and the results of the AND gate will be fed to the OR gate and we can get the output. So the delay will be less, and any Boolean function represented in standard form or the canonical form, okay, can be implemented as a two level circuit. Hence it is advised to avoid representing the Boolean functions using non-standard notations. In the next video lecture, we will discuss about the systematic procedure to simplify the Boolean expressions represented either in the sum of min terms or the product of max terms. Thank you for watching this video.